Again, there, fellas. Here we go. We got something unusual. Drake's Brewing Company, 1500. Dry hop pale ale, 12 fluid ounces. Independent brewery. San Leandro, California. Keep cold. I've done that. 5.5%. Let's give it a try. 48 whopping IBUs, you're kidding.
That's massive. That's good. It's what we want. Plenty of hopping. Hop it up. Get hopped. Oh, look at that. Lovely head on that thing. That's gorgeous. Independent brewery. That's what we want. Lovely little head. Cheers, everyone. Luscious. Wow, piney. It must have their hop farms here, some pine forests. It's really taken on the pine. And I know that because I live near some pine, a lot of pine trees. So when they that's lovely. They spit out a lot of dust anyway. And when they do that, it blows everywhere. It's sort of like the sperm of the pine. And that's wicked. That stuff is sold, actually, as an aphrodisiac. So that shit's blowing over their hops and giving it that piney flavor, backbone. It's really, it's subtle, but it really rides the whole beer. That's gorgeous. You know, you've got your hops. That fruitiness of the hops, you've got a pretty clean taste and pale ale with lots of flavour. Just dry hop to perfection. Well done, Drake's. You'll get a mention somewhere in the top 1500 because I've only done 2000 videos. So you're definitely in the top 1500. So well named. I could almost name 500 beers out of 2,000 I've probably tasted doing those videos. It tastes like shit. Well, you know, tastes pretty average. They don't get in the top 1,500 anyway. Let's put it that way. No, this is a great clean beer. If you like pine, you like that flavour. It's not too fruity. It's not over the top. There's no tropical fruit. We're talking a pale ale with a piney, sort of mountainous area sort of flavour to it. Lovely. Gorgeous. Oh, well, travel story. I'm watching a video now on all the planes coming in for the air show in Melbourne. So if you hear planes in the background, it's just one of those things I like to know about because I'm on planes all the time. I remember at one time, though, I guess that I'd flown on almost 300 different flights. And I thought, ooh, and that was a long time ago, you know, and since then I've done a lot more. But yeah, you sort of think sometimes when's your luck going to run out? When's one of your planes going to drop out of the sky? Yeah, it's a bit like that. When you do your first 300, it's nothing. When you get to about 500, you start thinking, shit, the odds are starting to come down a little bit. And I've been on little planes, I've been on tiny planes, I've been on all different planes, all around the world. And, phew, pretty scary sometimes. Skimming across trees, 50 metres above them, missing the ground by 50 metres, pretty trippy. Anyway, that's life. Get out and travel. Get some adrenaline pumping. Cheers, everyone. Love yous all.